Tell you what going on in France. So we had already a presentation last year made by some guys from the Agora, and so now not a professional one, but a community one. Thank you everyone for coming here. So the agenda for this talk is the first part was to talk about the role of peace development and support for the French state. With first time, what is MIMO? Perhaps you heard this last year. And then MIMO is supporting France and which company do this work. The second time, I will talk about what's going on in local authorities like cities or development, with some examples of your peace deployment in local authorities and what's going on. And also, I will talk about the UN project to improve. Improve your office with some vendors, with companies, and like what funding between the activities. And after that, we have some good news and some news about what's going on in France about free software and also in office. And I just forgot that we have some information about the community, also the slide between them. And of course, question and answers. So let's start with e-mobile deployment and support for France. So first the definition, what is MIMO? We heard about MIMO last year during the office win in France conference made by Inagora. So MIMO is not an organization, it's just a group of administration yes, that use e-mobile. For example, you have an Italian ministry inside this group, we have also financial, etc. LibreOffice, the MIMO group also made some LibreOffice version for themselves. Of course, because this version is made by some state, it's free and open source. Current version produced by the MIMO members are currently built by a company named Inagora. And if you want to see this, you can go to this page and discover exactly what is the MIMO group. And after that, so some departments like Interior, Gendarmerie, etc., use LibreOffice currently. And they have a support. So, for example, we have two big supports contracts, one for financial department, which is a Inagora company, and another one, which is also a Inagora company for other departments, because they have a contract for many departments. And any administration can buy some support with this tender. If you don't know something, or don't hesitate to ask me. And the previous owner for 2016 was Capgemini. Big computing corporation. So this support for the entire department has to support more than 200 software. The company that made the support is only 120 according to the Wikipedia page. So we have a big support contract with more software to support than people inside the company. I'm not sure it's quite normal, but that's only my point. Some parts are subcontracted with other companies, but LibreOffice is always made by Inagora guys. So the tender includes many software, including some of server, for example like Apache HTTP, PostgreSQL, some on desktop like LibreOffice of course, and some Windows, PDF, printer, etc. So there is a really big contract, and also some developer tools like CVS. LibreOffice is just one software in 200 software. So I think the LibreOffice project needs better support. I just switched the English. I think in Office deserve more attention and dedicated support, for example, with companies like CNP or Colabro. But that's only my point of view. So, some statistics about the current support compared to support to this company, with contribution with company from CNP to Red Hat. Those three are really good contributors. They make a lot of contribution. CNP started after, but all these three contributors are really good ones. And this is the neighbor. There is no money in chart. It's really small. In the government, we need to have added and removed 4,000 lines. That's really a small contribution to the project. So the Office project is about 7 million lines. If you want to check my statistics, please don't hesitate to go to the Segit repository, and I will provide you scripts to build statistics on the master branch. Is it fine? So, but those companies are not French ones, so I will compare this to French other contribution. So I made comparison from Negora to Ypres, Laurent Ballon-Courrier and Cédric Bosdonat. Perhaps you remember Cédric. He was a SUSE developer on New Office. So, the interesting point on this chart is Laurent Ballon-Courrier. He's not working in any kind of LibreOffice stuff. He's only a mathematics teacher in France. So it's only spare time. So we have to compare 8 years of contribution from Itagora for support to this guy who just do this on spare time. I'm not sure it's really a contribution from the world. So some precision about the contribution. So IPRA have only one developer, and most of the contributions are only made by a finance by a TDF tender about accessibility. So just one TDF tender can match mostly 8 years of support. Laurent Ballon-Courrier is a mathematician teacher I said before, who don't work professionally in office. So it seems, I think we can applaud Laurent Ballon because he made a lot of contribution. So if you want. Just for Cédric Bosdonat, he worked on the office at SUSE for 4 years. So normally, contribution from Inagora should be more than, should be around this contribution. And some statistics about date. For example, Inagora, Cédric Bosdonat was the first one on the project. After that, we have Inagora and Red Hat at the same time. But not the same level of contribution, of course. Laurent Ballon-Courrier started during 2012, CIB went in 2013, Live Collaborate Productivity, and also some IPRA during last year. And just a small example of what's going on this support, it was a potato technique. So if you have something too hot, you just drop this to the next one. And I'm sure if you know this technique, no? So for example, this bug was opened in 2014 by Capgemini guys. He's still active with still have commands, we had some commands in March of this year. And there is still no patch. This bug is still open with companies that should close it in 4 years. In 4 years and 2 days, I think. So if you want to compare to CIP and collaborators or with contributors, you can show those bugs it was costing about 1 month. Just to compare 1 month to 4 years of closing good. So what's going on in local authorities? So we talk about the legal office in state, but we have also local authorities, so we will talk about that. So some example, for example, we had some conference, online conference from Eric Michel doing conference in Rome and Bordeaux, so I don't want to just talk about that because we already have really great conference on this. Perhaps you noticed during the collaborative event with Michael Mix that LibreOffice Online was deployed in Côte d'Or, a department in France. In really good news, we have also the city of Grenoble that was looking to move to migrate their infrastructure to LibreOffice. And they hired a leader project for this. I hope that we work with Eric and Sylvia for the war, but I'm not sure. And we have also some other migration in France. For example, we have also to do that main migration. We have, I don't remember, some department also. I think also Perpignan made some migration.
Marseille.
Also Marseille. Thank you. And we have also a long-standing project to improve LibreOffice. For example, we had some improvement like pivot chart made by Nant, I think it was last year. We have a talk about that, made by Collabora guys. And there is also a long-term project, I don't remember exactly when it started, but it's a project made by Adulac. So Adulac is a French foundation to promote and help local authorities to use and migrate free software like LibreOffice or also their own product. It was created in 2002. The goal of the Group de Travail Task Force was to get money from local authorities that could make some development alone. So the demo. We made a contract with LibreOffice professionals like CMD, Collabora or Red Hat to do the real job. So if some collectivities doesn't have enough budget, they can share the fee to with the other group and work together to make LibreOffice greater again by contacting some stuff. If one to see, for example, the last meeting that talked about that it was the meetings here. And I was it. It's okay? And we have finally some good news after this support in France. And some information that was not some news, but.
Can you show the previous slide?
Yes, of course.
Oh, lovely. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Quite good as easy.
Some news in France that will encourage Bruxelles to contribute to the LibreOffice project. So we have state agents that now have a policy that allows them to contribute to free software, including LibreOffice. So now they can produce code and put this code on free software agents. We have also the version 2 of the RGE, or General Repository of Forum Interoperability, that defines ODF and PDF as recommended file format. We still have Office OpenXML in observation. In observation means like it's in the attic, like all the useless stuff you put in the attic. If you want to see a post on the state agent's policy, this link, and also for the general repository for interoperability, it's here. And we have also three software repositories used by France administration called the Software Internet Security, that includes a post for this. I think it was 100 or 200 per sector. I don't remember exactly. And the next one is some decision from the Commission for Accessing Administrative Documents. And administrative tribunal allowed people to access system or free software made for the administration. So, for example, some code has been on GitHub because of this decision. So, you have the decision and an article about this decision. And also, thank you, Sophie, for telling me that just before the conference. The DISIC, I'm not sure exactly what the CIC is, but it's hiring a project manager to work for free software contribution limitation in the state. So in every administration, this services is managed directly by the Prime Minister. And of course the community, and thanks to Sophie, of course, who's here. So, we have some French community events. For example, we had in 2017, we had a workshop and two this year. And we work mostly on QA and translation. We also present in summits in France. For example, we are in every year in Paris Open Source Summit. Also, Capital Ville, it's my city, so that's why we talk about that. And also MLM, so it's a free software worldwide meeting. And I hope we have more to see in 2018 and next year. A big thanks and some applause for Sophie to this community. See who is Laurent Malenvoyer, he's just here. That's going to happen.
People in the front from
ITRA,
this company working on accessibility.
Alexandre? And Elise on the right, just here. Yeah. Me, of course. Alors, here in the front, it was Sophie. And Jean-Baptiste Faure pour main translator.
It's a
great translator. Any questions?
No.